Well, bless my soul, what's wrong with me? I'm itching like a man on a fuzzy tree. My friends say I'm acting wild as a bug. I'm in love, I'm all shook up. Ooh, 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 yeah, yeah, yeah.
Well, this 50s cafe started about 19 years ago, just as a general 50s cafe covering the gamut of all the 50s characters. And then about the time the stamp came out, around 92, we zeroed in on Elvis. And it was shortly after that that we opened the Elvis Museum and began in earnest to dig into the proposition that Elvis is alive. The focal point of Elvis being alive is contained in this booklet, DNA Test Proves That Elvis is Alive. I was doing a radio show in Memphis when a doctor called in, asked me to call him after the show, which I did. He told me that he had material pertaining to Elvis that I would be interested in. It turns out that he was a close companion of the pathologist that did the autopsy on the body, which was purported to be the body of Elvis. And the doctor had specimens, extra specimens, of the liver tissue when Elvis was alive and did these biopsies. Subsequently, we decided that we would do a DNA to see if Elvis was truly alive or not. And when the tissue came back, the final result was that the living tissue of Elvis, known to be Elvis's specimens of his liver, did not match the person who was in the casket. And to me, that was categorical proof that Elvis Presley was not buried. Now, there's much more proof than that, but this was the real capstone. You can shake an apple off. With a little slogan, says it's rough and tough and doesn't take crap off of anyone, so. No serio. Stick like glue. Stick because I'm stuck on. We have a tape of songs that Elvis did after his purported funeral. This is Elvis talking on tape, telling why he faked his death, what he's doing now, and what his ultimate goals are. Elvis was a very emotional person, and In fact, the title of this picture is The Tear. And if you look closely, you can see a tear coming. They are very famous today as a... When you see these, you automatically know you've got an Elvis fan, because no one else would wear sunglasses like these if they weren't an Elvis fan. That's how love is gonna keep us tied.
I'm gonna stick like glue. Stick because I'm stuck on you.
About a year ago, I got a call from Elvis's only living aunt. She was married to Elvis's mother's brother, who was Johnny Smith. Her name is Lois Smith. And she's getting along in years, and she had some things she wanted to share with me about Elvis being alive. The primary thing that Lois said was that when she went to see the body of Elvis in the casket, she was shocked because Elvis, at the time of his death, weighed about 255 pounds. The body that was in the casket was a more slender person, about 170 pounds. And she said to the people there, "This isn't my nephew. Who have you got in the casket?" The security guards tried to hush her up, and she persisted, and finally Elvis's father got her out of the room and said, "I'll explain later, which she said he never did. But then she said something very interesting. Said her husband, Johnny Smith, who was the guard at the front gate at Graceland, came in one day and said, "Lois, you're not going to believe what Elvis said today outside the guardhouse. I am sick of this life. I have found a person who has a terminal illness. I have made a contract with them, and I'm going to use their body at the time that he dies. He's terminally ill, and people will think it's me. She said, Elvis said, we've been going to a face surgeon, and the arrangements have all been completed. And he said, this is exactly what happened, said the aunt. News people who have done interviews said, well, this doesn't look like Elvis. And my reply is, neither did the body that they had in the casket in Graceland that day. It didn't look like Elvis either. But this gives them a graphic picture that will help them as they read the documentations we have. Why it wasn't this Elvis? What is the evidence? Well, we've already showed you that the DNA proved that this body in the casket did not match, the DNA does not match the living Elvis. Secondly, the body that they buried, according to the coroner's report, only weighed 170 pounds. It is a known fact that Elvis weighed 255 pounds at the time of his alleged death. And the thing that I ask critics who say that I'm nuts about this is, well, you explain to me how a 255-pound man can lose 85 pounds going to the morgue. And if you'll explain that, then maybe I'll believe that Elvis is dead. Elvis had a $3 million insurance policy with Lloyd's of London, a term policy. This was never collected. Now, no one throws away $3 million, not even Graceland. Why wasn't it collected? Well, if Elvis is alive and had they collected this $3 million, that would have been felony fraud, and they would have been liable to have been convicted and sent to the penitentiary. Subsequently, that $3 million was never collected on. There have been voice print experts that have checked phone conversations between Elvis and some of his loved ones that were close to him, and the test showed that this was the voice of Elvis. This was after the funeral. There have been handwriting experts that have checked various documents that was written by the in the handwriting of Elvis Presley. After the funeral, they have verified that this was actually the handwriting of Elvis Presley. We don't go by sightings. We don't go by speculation. If we cannot document it as being a scientific fact, we do not claim it here in the museum. And I think that's been very important. This is little Elvis here, before he got bigger to where he didn't want to do them. This was him. He entered contests over in Kansas City. He was 8,000 people he got up and sung for. And
I won 10th out of...
There was 20 Elvises, adults, and he came in 10th. Just put him on and do a little Elvis pose.
All right. All right.
He's gotten too big.
At the contest, I didn't know it. I sat on the judge's lap.
Oh, he was about 5 years old then. He sat on the judge's lap. I said, no wonder you won. This woman judge fell in love with you.
Oh, yeah, I've run this place a couple of times.
Okay. He's run it by himself.
Yeah.
Yeah. That Carol has a day off. Every Tuesday she gets off, so he's the operator.
He cooks?
Yeah, he's 11, but he does a good job. A little large for his age. But he does a good job.
You ain't nothing but a hound dog, crying all the time. Well, you never caught a rabbit, and you ain't no friend of mine. Bye-bye.